Today, I am giving you an excellent tool to get your dog to better focus on you, and we are getting started right now. What's up, guys? It's Jenna with Dog Liaison, where I coach you to better enhance your dog's mental health. And on this channel, we like to break down scientific research to better inform us on how to better train our dogs. Today, we are talking about ways to get your dog's focus. Now, there are a lot of ways to get your dogs to focus on you. The foremost being that you need to be the most valuable thing in the space. You are constantly in competition with the environment around you. And if you're not the most valuable thing in the space, you're gonna lose your dog's attention. But under that umbrella, there are a lot of different tools, a lot of different cues that you could teach your dog. Watch me, look here, things like that. One of the best ways, in my opinion, is to teach your dog touch. Now, touch is just the behavior of getting your dog to put his nose to your palm. Now, it's incredibly versatile. I use it in a lot of different capacities. The foremost being that it gets the dog to orient where you want him. So if you want him by your knee, you ask for the target by your knee. If you want him by a specific wall, you ask for the touch by the specific wall. It's a way to position him where you need him to be without having to drag his leash and coerce him into a corner. The other reason that I enjoy touch is because it's the exact way that I ask for dogs to meet and greet strangers. So you want to think of like a handshake. In a handshake, a person meets out halfway, offers their palm, and then the other person offers their palm. And with a dog, that's exactly what we ask the dogs to do. The person extends out their palm and the dog walks up to the palm and puts their nose there and ask for a meet and greet. It's a much more structured way. The other reason that you might use a touch is to get the dog to do a specific trick, like spin, roll over, things like that. Anything that you might use a lure for. And if you don't know what a lure is, you might want to check out this video, because in that video I talk about why it's not necessary because you have a touch. And in that video I sort of verbally explain what the hand target is and why it might be useful. It's a very good video, but in this video I wanted to focus more on how we get the dogs to do it, literally the training process. So that's what we're gonna do today. Okay, so you're gonna start with your dog in front of you, and you're going to have your designated treats. I usually recommend starting this in a low distracting environment, which means that you can practice this with a medium or low value treat. And you're just gonna extend out your palm. Now your palm is gonna kind of smell like treats, but I do not want you to have treats in that hand. It should be empty. And you're going to extend it out in a reasonable space. Now, you don't necessarily want to put it right in your dog's face because that can be confrontational. But you don't want to put it so far that they have to walk up to it. It should be at a reasonable distance so that all they have to do is sort of extend their neck and their nose will tap it. Once your dog has looked at your hand, likely he's going to smell the hand and put his nose up there. Now, when you're practicing this, one of two things is going to happen. One, he's either going to just look at your hand and be like, why is there a hand in my face? Or two, he's going to actually just naturally incline to walk, to approach it because your hand smells and he wants to put his nose up to it. If your dog is naturally approaching the palm, the good news is that you can just capture this, and every single time that he puts his nose up to your palm, put yes and treat. If right now he's only looking at your palm and he's not actually putting his nose into it, then you're going to have to shape this, which means that you're going to start off with him just looking at the palm and then graduate the criteria all the way to the point where he is actually approaching it. Most dogs, though, are probably just going to naturally approach the hand, because anytime that there's a hand in my face, I look at it and go, what the heck, right? And if your hand kind of smells a little bit, then they're more likely to approach it too. Yes. Yes. Now you notice in this video that I'm just saying yes right now. I'm not yet saying touch. That's because he doesn't quite know what the behavior is. He's not exactly sure, certain of what behavior I'm looking for. It's not fair to ask a dog to do a cue that he doesn't know the definition of. When you say sit, 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 if he doesn't know what sit means, he's just getting frustrated at the sound. And it's the same with touch. We need to make sure that he knows the definition before you start giving in words. And that's one of the reasons right now I'm just saying yes. I just want him to make sure that he knows what behavior, what definition I'm looking for, and then I'll capture him and give him a treat for. Once your dog is doing well and is starting to understand the behavior, is starting to understand that he's supposed to put his nose to your palm, now it's time to start saying touch. And I want you to make sure that you're saying touch as close to the behavior as possible, because the further out they are, the more gap in between there is, the more likely it is that he doesn't know what you're saying or that he's not even listening. But if you can link that touch up to the behavior really close, he's much more likely to learn very fast what the cue is. Touch. Yes. Touch. Yes. Touch. Yes. Sometimes you're going to say touch and there's going to be a lag and then the dog will do it. That gap of time is sometimes inevitable, and I don't want you to beat yourself up over it, but it is important that you're trying to diminish that as much as possible, and that for the most part you're only saying touch as he's about to do the behavior and you're fairly certain that he's going to do it. Something to remember, and this is really important, is that you want to make sure that you're keeping your treats at a pretty neutral zone. If the treats are out and noticeable while the dog is doing the behavior, then you're actually just sort of encouraging a lure and you're not necessarily capturing or shaping a behavior. So we want to make sure that the treat is coming out after the fact. And again, the video that I mentioned earlier is going to explain why that's so important. So make sure you check that out at the end of this one. Once you feel like your treats are in the right spot, you're starting to say touch, you're ready to raise the criteria, now you can start to prompt him even sooner, where you're going to start to say touch a little bit further out, and then you'll look for that deliberate response. Touch. Yes. Touch. Yes. Touch. Yes. To start to generalize this cue, you can start to move the hand in different directions, maybe putting it over here, over here, over here, up, down. The one thing I don't suggest is to put it high off the ground, because that's just going to encourage jumping. But we want to make sure that no matter where the hand goes, the dog will target. The other way you can generalize this is by asking for a recall. So you're standing far away, asking for a distance, for a touch from about, you know, 6 feet or whatever, and the dog will actually come to you. So touch, like I said before, is very versatile, and you can use it as a recall if necessary. And finally, for expert level training, you can absolutely have your dog target other objects other than your palm. So because touch is the cue, not your hand — your hand is not the cue — because touch is the cue, you can eventually have your dog put his nose up to specific objects, like an X on the wall, like a person. And that is precisely what I do when I'm having meet and greets with a dog, is that, you know, the owner is the one that's saying touch, but the guest or the stranger is the one that's extending out that palm. So even though the owner is the one giving the cue and the reinforcer, the dog knows he's supposed to target the stranger's hand, not mom and dad's hand. Another way to generalize this behavior and make sure that it's nice and solid so that you can do touch anywhere, everywhere, under any circumstance, is to follow the 4D rule. And I highly recommend you check out this video, because in that video I discuss the 4Ds and how to make sure that a behavior is proofed under any circumstance. So use touch to get your dog to orient on you. Use touch to get your dog to know where he's supposed to be. Yes, it's true that you're going to have to use other behavior or other cues, like, you know, a name or watch me, something like that. Those can work congruently. They can work together. But touch is a wonderful, versatile behavior that I believe every single dog should know. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit like. Consider subscribing if you like a nerdier approach. And check out some of my other videos. And I'll see you guys next time.